goodness, it's a little brighter here than I expected. My name is Julie Dunn, and I am the Operations Director at Resurrection. And I am so delighted to get to have a chance to see you tonight. The sun is in my eyes, but I know you're here. I am so thankful to have this chance to give you an update. Thank you for your prayers. First of all, it's been 2 weeks since I announced that I would be retiring from my position at Resurrection. Since then, it's been a real whirlwind. We have been so blessed. God has been in every part of this experience. I am standing in front of our trailer because this is where we are putting a lot of our stuff. This is where we are going to put things that we're going to leave in Minnesota. And so we're going through this intense process of looking and examining and thinking about things that we want to keep and things that we don't need. And so it has really gotten me thinking about what is worth keeping. And more importantly, what are we going to be leaving behind? What are we going to be leaving behind for my daughter and our kids, for our grandkids? What is worth hanging on to? Oh man, there's a lot of stuff. I am an only child, and so I have a lot of beautiful things that have come from my grandmas and great aunts and great uncles. There have been beautiful, there's bowls and there's stitchery and there's crocheted pillowcases and there's all these things. And with each piece that I look at, there's a memory. I opened up one of the cabinets and I found this beautiful leather wallet. And as I looked at it and unfolded it, I had forgotten that it was a wallet that had belonged to my grandpa. And when I unfolded it all the way, it had his printing inside with his name. And embossed on it was the date of 1873. So that thing is 147 years old. It's crazy. And it's still in beautiful shape. And so looking at all of these things, all of these pieces, all of this stuff, I continue to think about what do I really want to leave behind? What is of value? If there was a fire or if there was a storm and if all these things were destroyed, what could I still leave behind? What could I leave in the wake of our life that would have meaning to those that are going to be following us? So I looked with that on my heart in the scriptures, and I looked at the book of John, and the verse is number 27 in the 14th chapter, and it says, "With you, my peace I give you. I leave you with my peace." Oh, I'm sorry. Let's start again. "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give as you give and the world gives. For do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid." I'm sorry. I really slaughtered that. But the point is, Jesus was talking about things that are not things. They're his love. They're his promise. His many promises of life with him, of hope, of peace. There's so much more that we can leave behind than crystal bowls and pillowcases and leather wallets. We can leave behind the hope in Christ for those that are following us, those that are around us now. We're struggling time and again. We are continuing to see people who are lacking and are struggling and don't know what real peace, real joy, what real relationships look like. They don't know. And so we are responsible. We're responsible for sharing that hope, because for those of us who have found Christ, it is our time to share it, to share His name, to share His hope, to share His love. And that is a legacy that we can leave behind. That is something that excites me. That is something that I am delighted to continue to share with all who are around me. We are going to be celebrating Pastor Lee's retirement on Sunday, the 6th of September, with an outdoor celebration here. And I invite you to come and celebrate this man who has shared this legacy, this commitment to creating and building up and raising up disciples of Christ, because he has a true heart for the love of Jesus and the love of his fellow man. And I want to be remembered like that. I want to live and leave that kind of a legacy for those who come behind, because Jesus is the one who showed us what true love, what true sacrifice is. And I am never going to be able to express my gratitude when I turn and I look back here to the crosses that are up on the hill. That is the place that I see the reminder of how much we are loved, how much I am loved, and how much you are loved. Jesus came for us, and so that is what I want to leave behind. Will you please pray with me? Lord, what a powerful and wonderful gift. It is something that we cannot repay. It is not something that we can recreate. It is not something from man's hand. It is only your grace, your love, and your sacrifice. So Lord, we lift our hearts in thanks. Guide us to have the confidence, the boldness to leave behind your name and your love. Help us to share this hope with those who are around us. We trust in you, we praise you, we serve you, and we thank you. In this we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for being here. Delighted to get to spend some time with you in the sunshine in this beautiful day. If you have any questions or any wonderings about what's happening, just check us out online. Until next time, thank you for being with us. Blessings on your night. Bye-bye.